Hi everyone, my name is Ian Van Tuyl, and behind me is a new listing of mine, a 2013 Jeanneau 57. So let me show you some of the features and benefits that this yacht has to offer. We're here in Newport Beach, California, and this is Wild Thing 3, the 2013 Jeanneau 57. This is a Philippe Rion hull design with collaborations with Jeanneau. It is a very smooth, powerful, stable sailing vessel. As you can see, we have a custom jet black painted hull with gold boot stripe and gold cove stripe. The vessel also has teak decks, inboard shrouds, triple spreader mast with satellite communications. It is quite the offshore turnkey cruising vessel. As we're making our way to the stern, you can also see that it has an isolated backstay for single sideband communications. The transom's quite nice, because as you can see, as it's folded up right now, we have a nice swim ladder that can accommodate off of that lower step, and then the transom itself will also fold down for the large dinghy garage. So moving up, we have the TrackVision KVH sat dome receivers. We have the Raymarine digital radar. The other really nice feature about this particular vessel is it has the double-ended main sheet that allows you to control the main from both starboard and port helm. As we move up forward, you look at the standing rigging. This is a diform standing rigging. So you can tell that by the flat edges. So this gives you the strength and very low stretch, just like rod rigging does. As we move up to the foredeck, we have a great sail locker here. This can be converted into a crew cabin, but as it is now, this is a great storage sail locker. We have a large anchor windlass. This is the Lumar. This is controlled by a windlass chain counter in the cockpit, and then also controlled here by this handheld remote. You can see we have all chain as well with a wash down here up at the bow. It's an electric factor furling system. So this allows you to furl and unfurl the sails from the cockpit as well. It also has a backup feature as well. So you can get a winch handle in here and or the spindle, creating another way to manually operate this. And as we look back, you can see just how beautiful this yacht is. It's very well maintained, and they've done a really nice job of all the installation equipment. As we move back, you can see the upgraded Dodger. This is a Memos custom canvas Dodger. So the Dodger has the macro long glass, and it also is convertible. So where these snaps are, this removes and this aft bow comes up. So it makes this like a windshield. It's very nice. Also have the integrated stainless steel grab handle here as well. But again, as we move it back, you can see just how large this cockpit is. It is pretty remarkable for a vessel of this size. Really can accommodate lots of people, but at the same time, again, it really focuses on single-handed use. So we have a dedicated winch for our main sheet and a dedicated winch here for our head sail. This is the newer style throttle system. So it's a little bit higher where the previous model years were down below. And then here at this helm, we have our windlass chain counter, our bow thruster controllers. This is the rocker switch for the electric head sail furler. We have the Fusion stereo remote. We also have all of our navigation lights, a multi-repeater. So this is depth, wind, speed, and then our autopilot controller. Centrally located is our Raymarine E140 wide hybrid touchscreen GPS plotter. This also has integration with the radar as well, along with communications down below, which we'll get to in a little bit. We have AIS tracking. So this is a multi-repeater that you can toggle through everything you wish to see here. And then another one located next to that. So you can have multiple different displays here. But again, it makes it really nice as you have the two-speed winches for both general winch and main sheet winch located here. and nice clutches. Everything led back to this area. There's a magma barbecue. We also have cleats that are properly led through eyelets to the cleats themselves. Underneath this is access to the dinghy garage, and then we have access to the life raft locker. So again, you can see just how nice it is to be able to come on and off the vessel. And with this ladder, this actually folds down when the dinghy garage is out, so you can get access into the dinghy garage area swim platform. And then it also closes up, really kind of enclosing the cockpit. So inside the cockpit table here is our 12-volt refrigerator. We have a lot of other storage. You'll see from the pictures, these leaves pull up on both sides, and it is quite an impressive cockpit table. We have electric cabin top winch that allows us to operate both starboard and port via electric. So this is furling in and out the main sail, and it also allows you to operate the spinnaker halyard. So as we come down below, one thing you're going to notice is this very large, wide open companionway here. The steps are quite nice and gradual. There's always somewhere to grab onto. We have the nav station off to the starboard side. The nav station is quite nice because it is forward facing, has a really nice area for you to work on. Underneath the nav seat is our washer and dryer. And then we have an ice maker located behind here. We have all of our main breaker systems behind this panel. This allows us to toggle between generator, shore power, all of our breaker systems for the main units. And then this is the quick operation here for like, you know, nav lights, electronics, and what have you. Here we have our ICOM 802 single sideband speaker, our ICOM 504 VHF, and then the Iridium sat phone, along with the hybrid touchscreen display here. There's also a RAM mic for the cockpit as well. So again, very, very nicely well done, all organized, and has all the equipment that you need. There are two air conditioning units here in the salon. This switch operates the salon table, raising it and lowering it. We have our Fireboy engine and generator fire suppression system. Our HRO water make, this is the remote's start switch and stop switch for the water maker. And then we have the upgraded Vectron Energy inverter charger located here. Salon is quite nice. This is the chocolate leather interior. This is the luxury salon table. So the leaves actually, this is in the full outright position, but the leaves also fold in, making it a small table, and then it'll lower down to make a coffee table. You have these two removable chairs, which are quite nice as well. Directly across from that is the large bench seat with integrated bar. That's quite nice. That just lifts up, giving you access for bottles and what have you. Directly across from the nav station is our galley. They've done a phenomenal job here with the galley. Lots of countertop space. There's a dish drying rack. We have double stainless steel sinks. We have a full dedicated freezer refrigerator with a side door access as well. Three burner stove and oven. An overhead vent that actually vents everything overboard, not just recirculates it here. And then a microwave. Directly aft of the galley is the aft port stateroom, and this has double berths here that actually will slide together and create one berth, or it's set up in a fashion so you can actually sleep two people here. It has its own private head and shower. As you see, this is a wet head, but it is quite nice and very easy to maintain. Lots of stowage. Every stateroom has its own television with a satellite receiver as well, so anybody can be watching different things throughout. So this is another look at the galley here. Salon, and I'm going to take you to the aft starboard stateroom, which they've had a custom mattress made. This is a king size mattress. So again, when you put those two beds together, it actually creates a nice large berth, but they had a custom mattress made for this. It has its own private TV with satellite controls. We have two nice overhead opening hatches. This is a very large one, and then a opening port to starboard. here in the head itself. Electric Japsco quiet flush toilets. Again, this mirrors the port side. Doors are quite nice. The hardware is fantastic. And then there's also magnetic catches for the doors, but they've done a really nice job, really wide doors, and the woodwork is quite spectacular. As you can see, this is the teak and holly floors, and that with the combination of the chocolate leather just really set it off. So here in the salon, we have, this is our second air conditioning heating control. This is our Fusion stereo CD DVD player along with the Track Vision module there. This is the 40-inch Samsung flat screen TV. And as we move up to the master, you can see just how nice this is. Ample amounts of headroom, lots of stowage. There's a full louvered hanging locker here, desk vanity area. This is the Samsung television for this stateroom. And again, every stateroom has their own receiver, so everybody can be watching something else. A very nice, large queen size bed. This is a custom mattress underneath this as well. And you have your own walk-in head and shower. Shower is quite nice because it doesn't take up a lot of room, but you have the smoked plexiglass doors that will encompass this area below us here. And again, Japsco quiet flush toilets that are fresh water, nice sink here, and a great amount of storage and a great design on the interior. This is all cabinetry stowage here and above as well. There are five opening overhead hatches in this stateroom. Well, I know this was a short video for the size of yacht that we're on. I know I didn't hit everything, but please feel free to look through the full listing. The link should be below in the description. And feel free to contact myself, Ian Van Tuyl, at any time, day or night. I look forward to hearing from you and hopefully earning your business and showing you all of the amazing things that Wild Thing has to offer, the 2013 Jeanneau 57. Thank you again.